Salut, comrades, and welcome back to Let's Play Victoria 2. My name is Vadim, and okay, let's see. I've skipped even more further. There is some events occurred. First of all, I'm next Prussia. Just for hell of it, because there was just I left only one province, and it was too easy for me to do that. Then what else? What else? What else? What else? Yeah, right now I'm warmongering like crazy. I declare war on loads of like German city states. Yeah, like Lübeck. That is the next right away. And then Mecklenburg is not quite yet, and I have, just for the hell of it, I declared war on Ethiopia, and yeah, why not? And actually, the next thing that I'm going to do is, let's see, yeah, I want to declare war on France and for this Elsass and Lotharingia. States, yeah, and actually French, let's see, French might be a pretty nice army. So as you see, they have mobilized their troops, and already they have shitloads of regiments. But it's, oh my god, these guys are not very in very good situation, but still. So I need to, yeah, go forward, attack, and why not? So let's see. Yeah, and as I see, Luxembourg is trying to hold off. So I shouldn't let him do it. And yeah, there is lots of troops. Like, no, not troops. Yeah, troops, by the way, too. Yeah, France isn't that small of a country. Right now they have 400 divisions. Not division, regiments. Yeah. And yeah, I need somehow to counter it. So I need loads of troops here. But thankfully, my Africa, because I have captured Africa, there is lots of troops to choose from. And let's just make my audio a little bit. No, not here. Game options. Not that loud, because it's annoying. Okay, then. Where else? Yeah, here. I'm surprised that mobilizing didn't make lots of troops here, but it's okay. Yeah, and here too. Africa. No, not Africa, but how it's called. Abu Dhabi, yeah. And this one too, because you see, they, for some strange reasons, annexed, how it's called? No. Makran, it is called. So, no French in America, for some reason. Yeah, a little bit of France in South America, but it doesn't matter. And all these islands are United States. Yes. I think they are free right now, in today moment. So, yeah, let's do it. So once again, is this big wars, I am not able to show you everything because, come on, it's too much of micromanagement. But you will see some a chunk of an action, and yeah, that will be, I guess, fun for you. Oh, for some reason. So let's see. Yeah, I captured. This is a Lubit, and oh my god, what is it? Fourth level 3. Oh yeah, that's the kind of problem. Because after some point, there would be forts everywhere, you know, all over the map, and it will be a very big problem to get them. To conquer a territory, even though it's just a small province, but still. So another useful windows is here, because you can see what battles are you in. So for instance, I see this is a troublesome battle, and here is another one, and we are fighting with a huge armies right now. So need to choose our generals properly. So this guy is pretty nice. Then we should check where French forces attack us or counter attack us. So we need lots of guys here, and let's give him a nice general. Then this battle isn't that scary. But for some reason I will send my guys here. And then I really need to start. No, not yet. I want to bait the main forces, French forces, because right now he has loads of troops here. Newly mobilized. And he needs some time to bring them to front. And to start fighting with them. And actually it's not a very troublesome thing, because you see all of their new mobilized divisions and regiments, they are not as cool as they could be. They have a low organization, like you see, very low, and they will suck badly, and then they will lose. And as you see, I researched this military doctrine, military directionism, yeah, and it's not that it gave me a bonus to morale and organization or something like that, but the main thing is research gave me a guess attack option. And as you see, all of my army received a plus 3 bonus to attack, and defense too, by the way. And it's like devastating, because it's a very strong advantage, very strong how it's called, a bonus, I guess, to fighting. And actually I discovered not only gas attack, but also a gas masks for my soldiers, so they will not. So attack against me would be inefficient, gas attacks. But still, and by the way, yeah, I conquered this way, and a chunk of land from Sardinia, Piedmont. Yeah, but gas attack, I discovered a gas mask, so. Not only I have a bonus, but if my opponent will research this technology, I will lose my bonus, but he will not be given his bonus. So it's like countermeasure. And actually this bonus will, I still cannot be defended. Yeah, so if my opponent will discover gas attack too, then both of us will have plus 3 bonus, and that means that both of us will suffer heavy losses and casualties, huge casualties. So yeah, I'm not going to sit and wait, I'm going to attack right away with my forces, Because why not? And actually, I have loads of divisions right now. This year I have 1500 division, and I'm number two in war score. Not war score, I mean military score. Yeah. And the Great Britain is number one right now. But they have loads of divisions in Asia and do not have lots of divisions in. And they actually have, but it's not that powerful. I could easily crush them anytime. By the way, can I build here? Yeah. And actually, yeah, about cavalry, I discovered all of possible cavalry unit. It's common cavalry, cuirassier, dragoon, and hussar. And the difference between them is cavalry is like a basic unit. Then cuirassier have more defense but less scouting. Yeah, as we. Okay. Then Irish dragoon have more attack but less even. Yeah, but the same amount as cuirassier of scouting. Yeah, they kind of like cuirassier have one less attack but one more defense, and dragoons have the same amount of attack and defense. Yeah. And Irish, Hussars have more scouting, yeah, so they are better in finding weak spots, but they are crappy in fighting itself. So they kind of useful, but as for me, I just built them on in even amounts, roughly, but I just. Just like dragoon, hussar. Yeah, I built less of cavalry, but still, because cavalry. Oh my god, how much it's 31 units, yeah, just from one province. So pretty nice. So we declared war on France. And there is lots of units that I can build in Africa. Yeah, actually, I forgot to tell you, I had a quick war with Ottomans once again. I've took a big chunk of their land. Yeah, so they are far from being a great power right now. Yeah, they are number 40. And let's see who is the leaders. Yeah, lag. Like military screen will lag a lot, because it's just so much of units here. Once again, what the fuck. So yeah. And I just want to see who is the greatest powers right now. So yeah. By the way, I'm the number one. United Kingdom is on the second place, but with lots of disadvantages. Yeah, their score is 3,000 less than mine. Then United States, but actually I cannot do anything with that, because they are too far from me, and the Alaska region is just not enough to conquer them. Then France, but I'm dealing with France. Like, this is the first French-Russian war, so it's okay. We will get them down in instant. Okay, Mexico is I cannot reach them too. Japan, they are close, but still I cannot reach them. So almost all of them, except United Kingdom and France. And France too, by the way, because I... This is the first one. So only United Kingdom is the country that I was in war with. Yeah, so and they're supposed to be number one. Like, it's almost a miracle that I managed to become the first, but still it's okay. And Netherlands, by the way, I had a quick war with them too. I've conquered a chunk of their land. Yeah, conquered Belgium, by the way. But still, or maybe I don't remember. Or I did it in the last run. So okay, it doesn't matter. If I yet didn't declare war on them, I will soon. Okay, a tough battle. So I need reinforcements, like badly. And yeah, these guys need reinforcements too. And it's too bad I had this province that I just locked my units there. And I think I lost ships, transports in one of my previous wars. Okay, then let's see. Yeah, this is a tough battle, but it's okay. Let's send some more. So about great countries, yeah, great powers. So United States of Central America is another one that I didn't reach yet. And let's see who is the following. India, by the way, yeah, India is my ally. Not my ally, but the country that I've created single-handedly by defeating British and freed them, their provinces, Indian provinces, one by one. But still, you see, it's about to get out of my control. Because they in the next couple of months they will be number eight and they will stop being a small country anymore and will become a great nation and stop being a secondary power, become a great power. So it's would be like I don't know, it's not very fun because. Yeah, they made British weaker, but still, they are not in my control, in my sphere of influence anymore. So then, Spain that I didn't reach yet, Portugal, Slovakia that I am controlling, Colombia, Denmark that I am controlling, two Sicilies that maybe I will declare war on them a little bit later. Hanover that I will conquer soon, Holstein, and yeah, Austria that I am controlling. And by the way, they are in my sphere of influence, and they are number 21, and other small countries. So yeah, guys, I think from now on, this Let's Play will turn into some kind of after-action reports, because it's I've explained lots of about game mechanics to you, and from now on it's only implementation of this knowledge. So I will just show you the results that I have with these tactics and strategies. So guys, on this note, that's it. Thank you for watching, and comrades, you are dismissed.